This just in, folks, death has struck again. China's Yangtze River dolphin has been declared a functionally extinct species after a comprehensive survey of the Yangtze River has turned up zero specimens. Now over to death with the full story.
After imminent threats to this species, including fishing lines, pollution, overwhelming boat density, developmental projects such as the construction of dams and floodgates, and underwater explosions, I was delighted with the task of eliminating the very last Yangtze River dolphin.
Oh, watch out, Tuwiga, she's a proper choo-choo. On a message from the dog of Angst to Grey Grimsby.
Disappointed to hear that my work has spurred various rescue efforts for other species, such as the endangered river pig. But I am pleased to know that I expect to be taking the life of a couple of other species very shortly. The first among these is the endangered hairy snout bean, a relative of the pea plant. Should habitat loss due to residential development, conversion to agriculture, and timber management continue to pose a threat to this plant as planned, I will be removing it from its northern Maryland range permanently.
Timber!
The second species I look forward to taking the life of is the salt marsh harvest mouse. Degradation of marshlands due to commercial and developmental abuses, flooding, invasive species, pollution, poor water quality, predation, and intense competition have all been assisting me in my endeavor. Soon, this helpless little mouse... Back to you, Clark.
What can we do to stop this madness?
Well, Clark, some actions have already been taken. In 1973, the United States passed the Endangered Species Act. Under this act, the government and citizens were prohibited from practices which could degrade or destroy the habitats of endangered species or the species themselves. Additionally, the production and trade of goods made from an endangered species was prohibited under this act. Also in 1973, the United Nations passed the Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Flora and Fauna. This was passed in an effort to protect endangered species by prohibiting the international transport of any endangered species body parts. 19 years later, in 1992, the United Nations passed another treaty entitled the Convention on Biological Diversity, which was intended to conserve biodiversity, promote the sustainable use of biodiversity, and enforce the proportional distribution of biodiversity benefits. We still have far to come before we will overcome death, but we are certainly on our way. Back to you, Clark.
Well, it's certainly a relief that we have some defenses against death, but it's up to you to help strengthen them. Find out what more you can do to help, and don't hesitate to act. That's all we have for tonight, folks. Have a great night.
Singing this. this will be the day that I die.
Darn, that's the end.